Well. This is actually very surprising. We're doing well, both on and off the pitch. Let's take a look. What's happening, folks, and welcome to an episode of the Orbit Road to Glory with Watford. If you're excited for this episode, hit the like button down below and subscribe daily if you haven't gone to on this channel. Can't breathe. And also check out my second channel, which has got my Ultimate Team updates on there and my Resident Evil Village Let's Play. And also check out Clear Mode on his channel as well. And the replay reviews are coming back. I'm just working out schedules in my head to work out how I'm going to do this. Don't forget, also Discord down below. Get involved in that. You can get in touch with me via DMs in there or our fellow community members. And also don't forget to check out the Twitch channel on Fridays, Saturdays, Mondays when I'm able to and I have the time to do so. So I did mention at the start of the intro there that we're doing well on and off the pitch. First of all, off the pitch, we are getting new facilities increased, the stadium expanded, and the training ground facilities improved as well. I am very surprised how this is going. This is all those little things we can do just to slowly build the club. It's going to be a long-term game, maybe mid-table for a while, hopefully. But we're definitely on something here, hopefully. So far, anyway, it could all fall apart very quickly on Football Manager, of course. But yeah, let's have a quick look how the games have gone. You may see a little hint of there what's happening on the screen there. But yeah, against the camera. Oh boy. Beat Newcastle by 1-0. Saar ball left hand side, gets ball to Klasinac, eventually gets the ball in the box here to Force Bowen, who puts him back in it for 1-0. And beat the billionaire owners by 1-0. It wasn't a stressful game really at all. Well, 1-0, I thought my end of the game might get nervous, but we kept our composure and we were good defensively. So 1-0 against Newcastle United, great stuff. Also beat Burnley by 2-1. A ball at the top straight to Hernandez, who gets it on goal. A lovely dink finish over the goalkeeper for 1-0. Really good start, and again, he's a constant goal threat, isn't he? Then this goal is absolutely hilarious. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to say a direct one mistake in the maker, because that is not, didn't directly cause a goal. I mean, like, it wasn't like he was an own goal or anything like that. But anyway, we recovered really well. Rose on the left-hand side, gets the ball in the penalty area. Who's there in the penalty, but Hines can fix it on, and 2-1, and we get the victory against Burnley. Again, these are kind of games that we're targeting to get points in, and we got them. And we could have scored more, but I'll take 2-1. Beat Aston Villa by 2-1. A very good performance again from us overall. And Saar got a goal, actually, in this game. Belting strike for 1-0. Nice to see other people score a goal. We got see the goal from Nicolas, and I thought, oh, God, here we go. A 1-1 draw, frustrating. But no, we recovered again. Rose gets the ball to Matic. Francis Oko, and watch this. Watch this. You have no idea how much I was screaming when that went in back in the net. What an absolute belting strike. And that's what I'm talking about. I'm not saying they should get like double figures, these guys, but they should be getting at least odd goals here and there. Another victory, 2-1 against Aston Villa. But the winning run came to an end against Liverpool, which is not a big surprise. It is Liverpool at Anfield in the cup. Mane gets the ball in the box. There's Salah, easy goal, 1-0. I wasn't too disappointed by this result based on the league results we'd have before that. I kind of expected it, to be honest with you. Liverpool started really well and we couldn't cope with them. A little ball at the top. There's Jeremy Pino, 2-0, and that was basically game over at that point. It could have been a lot more for Liverpool, to be honest. We didn't really threaten, but again, limitations. We kind of expected that kind of result. League two, we are currently 7th in the table, which absolutely blows my mind, based on how we started the season off as well. 5 wins out of 8. I'm not saying we're going to get in Europe. I don't think we're going to get in Europe. I think this is the early point in which we decide to get one of form. I expect a bad run at some point. But the further we can, if we can keep winning games in this form and just keep pulling away from that back from the bottom three, that most important thing. I think we can finish where we finished last year. If we finish 11th again this year, I'll take it. I think the most important thing is I'm looking at Southampton, Brentford and Luton, and they are not doing anything at the moment. They are really, really poor. We've beaten Luton already. The games against Luton, Brentford and Southampton are the games I'm targeting to win. Newcastle and Leeds, I think they'll be fine. I think Villa will be just okay. It's those, I think the bottom three, they're the three that we have to keep an eye on. Hopefully they keep losing points. So today's games, guys, against Man United and Fulham. Now, because the World Cup is coming up soon, I usually do a mid-season report. Now, I'm not sure where I'm going to do it. Most likely, I'm going to do the games against Brentford and Southampton next and then do it. Because I usually do it before the January transfer window, and I'm going to do it then because it's a mid-season break. Also, guys, interesting thing I want to talk about. It's something that you can give me your thoughts on in the comment section. The possibility of me trying to get a national team job. Now, obviously, not going to get one now, most likely. Though I could try and get a Russian job if I wanted to. I'll try a public job. But I'm thinking about doing that kind of thing on my careers. If I'm a big club, obviously it'd be easier. Or one of the top league clubs in the world, it'd be easier to get that job. But I'm thinking like, yeah, it'd be kind of cool to try to do both and try and win a World Cup and all the stuff in the club side of the game as well, all in one save. So your thoughts on that, guys? Obviously, I'm not saying we'll get anyone anytime now, but for future references down the line, shall we do that in saves? Let me know in the comment section. So, Man United, last time we came here, we got beat, was it 10-0, was it? And we've got to just do better than that. We're injured to Anel and Cathcart, who are out injured not too long. Good news is that Pichetto is now not being an ass. He's happy with his football time and dropped his unhappiness status, which is good. It means I can, if I do decide to sell him, I can get more money for him. We should be getting our asses kicked here today. Man United are very, very good. I expect better performance, a bit harsh, but I'm going to say it anyway. Let's see how we get on, folks, against Man United at Old Trafford. I'm not expecting anything amazing. If we get out of this kind of a decent performance, I will take it. Let's happen, folks. Old Trafford against Man United. Let's go. Man United now. Curling the far post. Edwards goal, and nearly a goal for United. Nearly a goal for United. That was a really good clearance off the line. And Ramsey yellow card, first chance United. Well, don't need to see the whole ball line technology thing, do we? But yeah, close for United to get a goal. Forward now, Klasinac, Matic, good ball, Klasinac. Can't find a ball in the box. He can. Ball in the far post. It's cleared. Well done, Nikita Sissoko. Luisa at wide to Bowen. Can he get the ball in the box? Oh, again, you've got to put the ball on the penalty area there, Bowen. You've got to put the ball on the penalty area before they close you down like that. Because now there's a break on now, which is the big problem. Again, you've got to press a bit higher than this. I get we're trying to keep our shape, but you've got to at least put pressure on him a little bit. Try and force him to do something. Varane, this feels like a goal. This is like a goal. Yeah, Rashford's not. Yeah, not tracked the runner again. Rashford, keep standing your feet. Stay on your feet. Ronaldo, and I knew he would score. I knew it'd be a goal. It all came from, we've got to swing the ball in the box in that right position. You can't try and work in the penalty area. Once again, though, you see, makes a movement. We don't track it, and then how is no one seeing Ronaldo there? Retreating. These two nowhere near him. Someone's got to realize, give a shout and say Ronaldo's free in the penalty area. Nobody works it out, and then you can't leave Ronaldo free in that penalty area. 1-0 Man United. Yeah, it's just poor. It's poor off the ball defending and not realizing danger. Throwing at Wan-Bissaka. Won the box. Ronaldo feared it. It's simple. We shouldn't be losing goals to crosses. I don't care who's in the penalty area. I just feel heading is still very effective this year. I really do. This is just really poor again. Makes a movement. Nobody goes with him. It's, again, off-the-ball defending. That is the biggest problem we have. And right now, until we get better defenders, I think it's going to be a constant problem against top teams. Shaw. Pogba. Rashford. Pogba. Twanzebe. Again, we're not pressing enough. There's no point in you pressing, Andes. You must stand there. No point in you pressing, mate. Because you just... Fernandez. Van der Beek. Again, no one. Again, Sar, work harder, mate. Go get him. One in the box to Ronaldo. Cleared again. Again, we're just second every single ball. Pogba. Again, it's not hard, Sar. Mark him up. And that's 3-0. He's not offside. He's not offside. Sar has just got to... I should have to tell him to do this. When he's looking at him. Mark him up. Mark up the fullbacks. I don't like doing this, though, because, again, I've said before, I think the man marking for system needs to be working on Football Manager, because it doesn't have intelligence in it. I think that's a goal. I don't think he's offside. I think Rashford's onside. Yeah, thought he was. Again, yeah, proceed. Again, you see, look, you watch the goal again. Slow reaction, everyone too deep. Only one guy trying to get the ball, and that's Bowen. And then, once again, Sarr doing nothing there. Ignoring the issue. First hand cross. Again, wrong side of him. It's, again, the movement's too good, or the defending reaction is too poor. And 3-0 down, and it's becoming a deja vu again at Old Trafford, isn't it? Half time. it's kind of game, which I don't think we should do live comps on anymore. I really don't see the point in doing them. It's just, we're never going to win them at the moment. We're going to get the odd free because you're in there. But there's not much to show from it being the free goals. I'm going to just flash my arm and say, you've been terrible. I think a lot of our goals can be sorted out by... should I go to your key highlights? I did just before the third goal went in. Because, no, go extended again. Go extended again. But yeah, we just need to just book our ideas up. What is that? Out for a corner or for not across the penalty area. Cross comes in. There's Ronaldo. Van de Beek. And that is four. I don't think they're playing that well United. I think we're just... Every time we play against Man United or any kind of decent side away from home, we have a defensive frailty about us at times. That's a goal. He's onside. Oh, wow. I was convinced he was onside. He's onside! What? Oh, I can't change the angle on this, can I? He is onside. How is he not on? I get it's a goal for United, but how is that a thing? I'm putting that on the forum. That is definitely a thing that he's looked at. He's clearly onside there, and they just don't understand. Oh wow, hilarious. Well, it's not as bad as last time, but I think every goal we've scored, we can prevent it by just being ball switched on the back. Then it goes to a shot cleared. It should be 4-0. I think the VAR messed up there for them. That's when we're clearing it, Louisa. But yeah, it's the kind of game we just write off as one of those games that we're not going to win. Good news is, I think Southampton have not won their game, so relegation battle's still in a good position. But yeah, it's the kind of game I think we need to write these games off when we get into them, because... I don't think United were that good. I really don't. I think a lot of the goals were down to the slow reactions and lack of awareness. But it's not the games we need to win, really, is it? No, I'm going to say enough, please. No, we can lose a game like that, but lose better than that. Anyway, Fulham next. The downside now is that going to affect our confidence going into this next game? Hopefully not. Right, folks, here we are, match number two against Fulham. And good news is Brentford and... I think Brentford and Southampton both lost recently. Brentford lost, and I think Southampton are playing someone half decent. I'm sure they were. Anyway, we are still in a good position. I think these are the kind of games we can bounce back in. My big worry about these games always is, when you got our ass handed to us in the last game, are we now going to have an issue with just the whole... lack of morale issue. But we'll see what happens, folks. I expect to see a better performance tonight. Actually, I do. But Fulham aren't in great form either. Let's see what happens, though. I mean, I think we've achieved a better start than I thought it would in this season. I really do. I think the fact that we're top of the table and good pushing Europe is actually very impressive. So we'll see what happens today, folks, against Fulham. Third times they want ball to play, but they don't have the belief to play it. Sissoko, that's an interesting ball. Again, into space, not directly to them. Fullback careful. Get it forward. Again, they're taking too many touches in these areas, and it's causing us problems. Saar, driving forward. Needs to get a pass off here. Ball making a run down the right-hand side. Hold it up, ball. Hold it up. Done well. Back to Luisa. Now Bowen. Bowen with a chance. Luisa, yes! Watford 1, Fulham 0, we've got the lead. I'm always wondering when they get down the right-hand side whether they're going to actually mess this up or not. But they did very well there. Well done, Bowen. Hold the ball up there. With a support. Found Louisa. It's not probably how you pronounce it. But nice little play between the two of them here. Bit of fortune for Barton, but lovely little finish. Back of the net. 1-0 against Fulham. Get in there. That's exactly what I wanted to see. Not much happening at all in this game at all. Really not. Klasnak, down the left hand side, curls in penalty area. Bowen's in there, it's clear into the box. Sissoko picks it up. First time pass if you can. Okay, he's found Matic. Matic, he might shoot, you know. Nah, he's gone back to Sissoko. Matic, Luisa, Bowen, Akita. Can he find a ball in the box? He's found Luisa. Swing the ball in, please. Up against United. Good ball. Bowen. Crystal Hernandez. 2-0. Oh, I'm loving this team right now. I'm starting to see things that I've been trying to get them to do for over a year. This bit of movement off the ball. You know, this Camassie, look, that pass there, bit of movement. Bowen, first time cross. It's first time, it's better movement I'm seeing, and the first time passes in attacking areas. 2-0 against Fulham. This is going very well this season. Half time, it's been very, very positive. I'm very pleased what I've seen in this first half from us. I'm going to say happy things are going. Keep it up. This is a much better, this is a positive sign that we've got beat United convincingly, but they've come back today and they've performed well. They've had two really good chances in the game and they've taken them both. That is really, really good to see. Key thing is that I can get a couple more and really get some confidence going again. I just have to check we're only extending the highlights because there's been no highlights second half having the kickoff, but we aren't extending the highlights. Thought I could get it on, but clearly not. Bowen. Interesting ball. Sal's got that. That boy, see, I said earlier, I don't think he's going to make the cut, but I said before, into space. Let our pacey wingers run onto it. Sar. Crossed it in to Hernandez. Blocked. And there's a reaction from Sar. Can he get a ball in the box again? Matic. Sissoko. Matic. Luisa. Good ball again. First time cross. Okay, not quite. Oh, it's 3-0. There we go. Watford 3. Fulham 0. And I know, right? This is actually very impressive what we're doing here. This could be... I'm not gonna say anything, but this is exactly what I want to say. I will point out though, again, I do have a go at myself. Fullback not being marked, and then William Klasenac, good ball in. There's Nandez who slides in, and it's 3-0, and I think that is probably game over. This could be the highest scoreline we've had in a league game on a live com for quite a while. 3-0, brilliant. Hopefully we can get some more. Sar, Matic, maybe we'll get another one here. That's a poor pass. But again, the reaction is there to give it. Who's Paul Matic? Been brilliant Matic in this team. I'm delighted with him. Klasenac. That's a poor pass. Just maintain the focus, lads. Don't give me back to the game at all. I see. Movement off the ball. Well done, Anel. Well done. Okay. That's interesting. I think he rushed that. Tete Dolin cross it in. Dolin cross that in. Well done. Body in the way. Shot coming. That's perfectly fine. Just get in the way of them. Don't make it easy for them. Soko. Matic. Good ball to Bowen here. Bowen controls it. Luisa. Far post cross to Sar. Control it. Well done. Finds Klasenac. Klasenac to Sar. Oh, just didn't get the shot away before Soko followed it up. Well done. This is really impressive football. Ooh, way of a pass there. He's got it back. He's got it though. Give him support. Finds a cross. And again, Matic not got the pace to get there, but he could have really worked it out. Oh, what a response this has been. A 3-0 victory over Fulham. And again, it's the game we're targeting. We've got to, and it's actually a convincing performance as well. It's not like the games where we win 2-1 where we play well, but we just narrowly win. We actually scored 3 goals in this game, which is great to see. And Luisa and Hernandez again. He's so good for us. Very proud of your performance out there. We are in dreamland right now. I am very impressed with how we are doing. And we are basically we're in Europe. It's insane. I don't think we'll stay there. I think there's going to be, but there's definitely something here. This tactic is working. I think all we've got to do is buy better quality players for this role. And I think we're on something here. The story's not about you, but look at that. We are 19 points and basically, what is it? 11 points clear of relegation already. I think we're going to stay up this year. I really do. I think we'll stay up. This early start has given me the confidence that we'll get there. I mean, last year, what was the points total we got last year? I forget off the top of my head. We got 47. We're basically halfway there. Essentially, already to the points total already that we had last year, and I just don't see these bottom three catching us wasting their current form. And I think the players we've got, I think we'll be fine. Right. So next episode, Brentford's. Oh, we've got to do Brentford's advance, haven't we? We've got to do that. They're two relegation battles. Win those two games, and we're laughing, aren't we? So we'll do those two games next, because then I'm going to do a mid-season report, and give you guys a chance to get your thoughts in for the January transfer window about players maybe looking to sign and target, maybe that ideas and that kind of thing. I usually do it around December time, and with the it's not gonna be quite mid season, is it? It's gonna be before more games, so it'll be roughly about where we do it anyway. But first of all, it's our series. We can do what the hell we want. Guys, hopefully you enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed the episode, and I hope you have, surely you have. We're in seventh in the table with Watford. How can you not be enjoying this? If you have enjoyed it, hit the like button down below. Subscribe if you're new as well. Don't forget to check out Secret Channel down below. There's some long affiliate content on there. And my Twitch channel and Discord. All that stuff, like I said, down below. Well, until next time, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.